Roland Sonic Cell is a portable yet very powerful 16-part multi-timbral sound module. Not only is it outstanding in sound quality since it uses the Phantom Series engine, but it also acts as an audio interface for your DAW applications via USB. To make the Sonic Cell integrate easier into your recording environment, it comes with a software editor. The software editor can either be ran as standalone, or as an audio units or VST plugin. Now, Roland has updated the Sonic Cell to version 1.20, adding full RTAS compatibility. This means that you can open up the Sonic Cell editor within ProTools LE, ProTools M-Powered, and ProTools HD as an RTAS plugin. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the Sonic Cell RTAS editor using ProTools LE 7.4. We'll also cover how to sequence the multiple parts from the Sonic Cell and even automate them. Before we start, we need to make sure that the Sonic Cell is in performance mode. Press Menu, scroll down to Sound, and switch it to Performance. Here we start with a new ProTools session that's empty. We need to add one audio instrument track to load the Sonic Cell editor onto. Go to Track, select New, choose Instrument Track, and we want to make sure that it's mono. And click on Create. Now we need to add a few MIDI tracks to actually record our MIDI performance on that will be used to trigger the Sonic Cell. So we go to Track, New, and now we'll select MIDI track. And for this demo, I'm going to use 6 MIDI tracks, but you can always select more if you like. Remember, the Sonic Cell is 16-part multi-timbral, so you can trigger up to 16 parts at once. And click on Create. Now let's add a click track for our metronome. Come back up here to Track, and scroll down here and select Create Click Track. And we have our click track at the bottom for our metronome. Okay, so let's go and open the Sonic Cell editor on the instrument track. Simply click on the Inserts tab, select Plugin, then select Roland, Sonic Cell Editor, RTAS Mono. Now let's choose a sound to sequence on part 1 from within the Sonic Cell editor. Under Part in the Mixer screen, click on the Categories button. This opens up a separate window with a menu that allows you to browse patches by numeric order or by category. To browse by category, simply click on the little downward arrow up by the Patch Bank Category window. I want an electric piano sound, so I'm going to go ahead and choose EP. With your MIDI keyboard controller connected either through USB or directly into the Sonic Cell's MIDI in port, you can play and audition the sounds in real time. Simply click on another sound or preview it, or select a whole new category. So let's choose this stage phaser. With the Sonic Cell RTAS editor, it's very simple to navigate through the sound banks and quickly find that sound, play, and record. Now that I have my electric piano sound, I'll choose MIDI track 1 within ProTools and start recording. To select sounds for other parts and MIDI tracks, simply follow the steps I did for part 1. Now I need a low bass type of sound, so I'll go within the Sonic Cell RTAS editor and click on the category button on part 2. I'm going to browse for my sound and select this garage organ, which I can use as a bass tone. Now select MIDI track 2 within ProTools and record my newly selected sound. I'll add a few more parts with sounds from the Sonic Cell to really add some life to this demo song. So now I'm going to choose another sound for MIDI part 4. Open up the RTAS editor for the Sonic Cell, and I actually have a custom lead sound that I made using the editor, and then I stored it in the user section. So if we come down here, there it is, Mike's Edge lead. We can preview it from here and select that. So So now that I have a few parts selected, we'll go ahead and make the arrangement and add the vocal track and a backing track with some drum loops. Okay, so as you can see here, I have my full arrangement. I've copy and pasted a few regions. I've also renamed my regions, and I've renamed the MIDI tracks to reflect the sounds that they're playing from the Sonic Cell. So SC EP, Sonic Cell EP, Sonic Cell Bass, Sonic Cell Piano, Sonic Cell Synth, the Sonic Cell Drums and Percussion, some hi-hats from the Sonic Cell, and a nice big pad sound from the Sonic Cell as well. At the bottom here, you can see I've also added a vocal track, and I've added some drums and breaks to kind of fill in to play alongside the Sonic Cell as well. At this stage, I want to mix my sounds properly, so I'll open up the Sonic Cell RTAS editor again and make my adjustments to the sounds from the mixer page. Let's go ahead and start. As you can see here, we have control over the volume on the EP sound. Bring it up, take it out. Even make adjustments by adding more reverb just from the reverb sends right here in the mixer window. The best thing about this setup is that all the sounds and effects are running off the Sonic Cell, which means there's no CPU drain on my computer, leaving me more room to add other RTAS software instrument plugins. One last thing I want to do is draw some filter automation on part 4 of the Sonic Cell. So let's go to part 4. And adjust our height to large. And we'll simply assign controller number 74, which is the cutoff, to the track view selector section on MIDI track 4 within ProTools. I'll click on the pencil tool and select line. This allows me to draw straight lines of automation on my MIDI track. And let's say we want to slope that filter up here. And maybe from here we'll draw it back down. And let's solo this part really quick and take a listen. Nice. You can hear the cutoff filter start to open up and bring that sound out. So let's put this back in the mix and let's play it all together. And I feel that it's only a little while until I'm not too tense. And I'm always longing for tomorrow to see you again. Now finally, let's not forget to save our ProTools session. Click on File, and just select Save. That's it. The best thing about using the Sonic Cell RTAS editor is that when you save your ProTools session, it automatically saves all the sounds you had called up within that Sonic Cell performance. When you come back and open this ProTools session again later on, it will automatically load up all the sounds you've used from the last session, and this includes any custom patches that you may have made. The new Sonic Cell 1.20 update with RTAS compatibility is available as a free download from the Roland US website for all Sonic Cell users. Please visit www.rolandus.com for more information. My name is Mike Acosta. Thanks for watching.